leader of the Socialist Party in Canada, Jack Layton, died. And that's been rough for all of us because Jack Layton was this vibrant personality that attracts people's attention. He brought the party from the bottom of nothing to the point where it is now the official opposition of the government of Canada. And just by a few seats, we could have won the country. Could have taken over the entire country. But it didn't happen. Because 3 months after the election, he died of cancer. So anyway, I got delayed going to Australia because I trusted some church people and trusted a minister. I mean, I couldn't get the passport because you need a birth certificate, which I couldn't figure out where it was. So I had to apply for another one, which is no problem, but you require a guarantor. And it has to be somebody that you met, that you've known for 2 years, and they got to be in a specific profession. And so I need a new passport, and I need a guarantor for that. You know, and I know a bunch of church people known me for over 20 years, 25 years, and all of them backed out. Nobody would sign it. So I had to get somebody from work to do it. No problem. And then when it came to the birth certificate, I contacted a minister that I'd known over 25 years and completely ignored me, like I didn't exist. Wouldn't write back, wouldn't acknowledge the messages. So I was stabbed in the back by the minister, which still set up a huge delay. Getting the passport, because now I needed the second person that could do it was another person who was a nurse, but they're living in Florida in the United States, and I had to contact them from Canada. And unfortunately, the day I contacted them, they were giving birth, so they're spending all their time with the baby and whatnot. I don't have a telephone. I just have email, and they're not. So they're not looking after the computer, they're just focusing on the new baby. So I am delayed. I'm going to be delayed, it looks like, to the end of September, beginning of October, before I get to Sydney. You know, and if I got to go and it's going to be boiling hot, then so be it. And I will be there. I'm not. Anyway, Jack, I'm going to toast a victory to you. Jack was a musician. Jack Layton. And the guy loved beer and he didn't mind pouring it for other people. But I don't like beer, Jack. So I just got caught. So I toast our victory. Why did it have to end? We almost made it. It's a conservative party. They have no magnetic leaders. The liberal party is filled with a bunch of God, I don't even know how to even describe the Liberal Party. It's like, oh my God, these are... But the Jack Layton, he had this magnetic personality that could attract attention to people and support. And, you know, the... Oh my God. The Socialist Party, the main Socialist Party in the country, almost took the country. By just a few votes more, we would have been leading this country. And it made the business community extremely nervous because they knew, the business leaders knew that instead of paying no taxes at all, they'd suddenly have to pay taxes. And corporations would have to pay their taxes, which doesn't happen under the conservative government. But it was so close, almost made it. Like in the week leading up to the election, the business community, the major corporations were scared because suddenly Jack Layton's party, the Socialist Party, were going way up in the polls. It looked like they were going to win the country, and we almost did. And 3 months later, we lose Jack Layton to cancer, and there's nobody to replace him. So we've lost the country. There's no way in hell we're going to win the next election. But it was so close. Ah, oh, Jack, why? But anyway, here's to you. Anyway, to Jack Layton. Sorry, Jack, I don't like beer. See you in the resurrection, even though you didn't believe in it.
On Chewbacca Road, and I would go inside, right, and just walk around, and then I would have these nightmares where they came home and I couldn't get out, and I couldn't disappear.
I fell in love with Olivia in 4 nanoseconds. I wasn't sure exactly what I was getting into, but I knew that I was smitten from day one.
But if my silence